That was one of the big reasons, you know. My life was ready for another change again, and I felt really that I'd done at that time really all I could do with the show, you know.
Matt, let's go back. Matt Borlenghi, here we are sitting at the Beverly Hills High School. Come on, Matt.
My alma mater.
How does this feel, Matt? I'm interviewing you here at the Beverly Hills High. Is this where you went to school?
Yeah. And to walk down the hall was, you know, to the door. Right. I still got lost, but
did you really?
I got lost. Uh-huh. But looking around, I remembered exactly where I was when I looked down the hall and saw that the patio outside to the right, and then knowing that I used to have lunch out there all the time, and then the library up around on the other side. I mean,
was it fun growing up here in Beverly Hills? Coming to this school, especially.
It had its ups and downs. I mean, I'm not an angel. I mean, I got into trouble.
When they see this really 9006, is it, or what?
902, get out of here, really.
Is that what this is called? When they see that in Orange County or in Missouri, is it really like that when you were growing up here?
No, and that's been really frustrating. I mean, I've always said that all these kids that are, and they're not really kids, are they, involved in that show, I'll always wish them success as long as it runs, you know, just like I did for all the people with Charlie's Angels and Fantasy Island, if you get what I'm saying, you know.
Right.
It's gonna pass.
Right.
The most frustrating thing about it has been that while it's great that the success has been there for them and a lot of people are interested, a lot of people are getting a really warped version of what it's like. I mean, that's why it's just to watch. Just the opening of the show, just to see. I mean, it's not Beverly High.
It's not Beverly High.
No, and if they called it Akron, Ohio 06122 or whatever, you know, no one would watch it. It's because of the Beverly Hills mystique, which really, I mean, I don't like that. For me, having gone to school here and always having heard that, ooh, Beverly Hills.
Yes,
I mean, I never saw what was so great about it. Uh-huh. I mean, now I'm old enough to really appreciate some of the things, you know. I was lucky that my parents didn't spoil me rotten, you know, like a lot of people. I mean,
Matt, you're sitting
I never
there.
Went for wanting, you know, granted. Uh-huh. I never went for wanting real, you know, if I needed something. I always had a good pair of shoes on my feet, but I mean.
Mother's Italian.
Oh, yeah.
She's an Italian countess.
Yeah.
A real Italian countess. And that makes you
a count.
A count.
Yeah.
But you don't use that title. You don't, it's no reason for you to use it. Is that it?
I'm just a guy.
Just a guy.
I'm Matt.
Matt Borlenghi, when you decided to become an actor, at what age? I mean, you knew when you were going to school.
I knew
when
I was seven.
Walking down the halls.
I knew when I was seven. It was way before Beverly that I knew.
Really?
I mean, it was elementary school at Hawthorne, you know, another Beverly Hills school.
Right.
Seven, eight, nine, I'd be walking along the sidewalk thinking, where's the camera? What's going on?
Really?
I mean, I was silly. It was like I had such a romanticized idea of what acting was about. I mean, I had that crazy thought that if I was standing at the stop sign pretending I was in a movie, that some guy in a limo was going to pull up and say, you're the kid for the next feature. I mean, but that's part of growing up.
Uh-huh. Studied? You've never studied?
Oh, no, I studied.
Did you study?
I studied plenty.
No, before you went to movies, did you study before that?
Sure.
Oh, did you really?
I started here in the theater classes.
At the Beverly Hills?
Under an old coach that used to be here. He's not anymore. He left the year after I left. His name was John Engel.
Okay.
And he was really, really nice guy.
Uh-huh.
I was, 15, 14 when I started here.
Uh-huh.
As a sophomore, I went to private school for freshman year, but here and then other places like the Strasberg Institute and Tracy Roberts.
You did some extra work for it. You wanted to do some extra work to see the other side.
I did a lot of extra
work.
You
wanted to see the other side of it.
I just wanted to see everything of it. You know, I wanted to see what a C stand was. You know, and now I know what a C stand is.
Uh-huh.
And there's no, if you're gonna be in this business, I think the best thing you can do is build as many little, you know, steps on the ladder for yourself, because no one's going to come pulling you up.
Right.
Without.
Now, you did a film. It was called The American...
It was a nightmare called The American Scream.
Yeah.
And, you know... That was
your first feature film.
That was my first feature. And it was really... it taught me a lot about work. I mean, I thought that the pressure on all my children was heavy, but here I was shooting 20-hour days on the American Scream,
right?
Because it was maybe 2-3 weeks of principal photography, real
right.
fast, low budget, and literally making sure I learned my lines
right.
between little catnaps on the set.
Right.
You know?
Right.
So I can't say that I was really prepared for
uh-huh.
it, but it was a good experience.
But then you did some TV starring on some guest shows.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you've done a lot of, some shows for me you've done.
Episodics.
You've done Hunter.
Hunter was the final one.
The final thing on Hunter.
It was a minute scene with Fred Dreyer.
And that's where all my children saw Matt Borlenghi.
That was it.
Come on, Matt. They saw you, and they said, hey, we want that guy.
The morning after it aired, morning after it aired, I got the phone call.
They knew. And they screened you, they had you flew to New York.
Well, there was a little process where first I had to meet the head lady out here, and then they screen tested me at the General Hospital set.
Okay.
And then they sent the tape to New York, flew me out there for another screen test,
uh-huh.
and that was on a Thursday. Friday in the airport at JFK waiting uh-huh. to come back, I checked my machine here in L.A.
Great.
And there was the word that I was starting work on Tuesday. So I came back here, got two duffel bags and a couple boxes, and I was living in New York Monday.
Matt Borlenghi got very excited.
Oh, yeah. Matt Borlenghi went
right
through
the
roof.
What were you thinking of when you were on the plane going to New York at the time? What was Matt Borlenghi thinking of going to...
I was thinking of trying to find an apartment in a week because they were willing to put me in a hotel for
uh-huh.
a week.
Uh-huh.
So Sunday I was checking the Yellow Pages looking for places to call on Monday.
Uh-huh.
Monday I found a place, had an apartment already before my first day of work Tuesday. And also, I mean, I can't say I was really... had a million things rushing through my head besides just basically relocating.
Right.
Because it all happened so fast that I never really had a chance to sit there and say, okay, the reality of what's happening right now is I'm about to be on TV every day.
Uh-huh.
You know, I never really took time. And by the time that started kicking in, I was already on TV every day, and it was just a regular thing. I mean, my ex-girlfriend and I
uh-huh.
would be walking through the streets, and someone would say something, and we'd look at each other and say, oh, yeah, that's right, I'm on All My Children. Wow, I'm on All My Children.
Was that exciting for you, wasn't
it? It was
something. It's not just exciting, but that's work there. You had to get
it's
up. What time of the day?
Work.
It's hard.
I woke up on an average of 6:30.
So, scripts constantly being changed.
Yeah, you get your changes when you get there in the morning.
It's hard work, Matt.
Exhausting.
I mean, from six, you're up there 6 till what time? Late at night?
Well, generally it was 12-13 hour days. You know, there were times when
So you're saying the movie was that screen? The screen was harder than that, Matt?
Well, because I knew it was just short term. You know, with All My Children, I mean, it's an ongoing storyline that takes its curves and twists.
Right.
You get to know the character, you know, and I got to know, and I felt comfortable about giving Brian Bodine a little bit of Matt Borlenghi.
What a strong name.
Soaps always have those names. I mean, Brian Bodine, Trask Bodine, my older brother, you know.
But Brian Bodine became a big star, hunk star, overnight, though.
Yeah,
look at the fan mail. You must get a lot of fan mail, did you?
Yeah.
A lot of them.
Was very fortunate, you know. A lot of people tuned into what I was about, and... Really,
what
really
is Matt Borlenghi really about? Come on, I know you're not just you know, you're a nice young man from Beverly Hills who wanted to be an actor. But there's more than just because you left that soap, you want to come back. There's a little more seriousness about Matt Borlenghi.
I started at times as exhausted as I was by the work of All My Children, and as much as I wanted to dive into it more,
right.
and I'm curious to know what would have happened, you know, if I'd stayed there. But at the same time, I have no regrets by leaving. I miss it sometimes. I miss the people, you know. Uh-huh. When I see the people on a talk show or something, I watch, you know, because I want to, you know. And going back for awards ceremonies, I get to see everyone.
Right. Matter of fact, you just got an award.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
A week after
I moved back to town.
A week after you moved back.
Yeah, the same week.
Let's watch this award, okay?
Okay.
It must have felt funny you got this award after you're back in town.
It was a little strange, but it really meant a lot because the soap opera award is voted by the fans, you know. So
the fans vote this.
Yeah. The editors and the magazine, you know, they pick who they think should be voted on, and then the fans narrow it down from a field of 11 to a field of 3.
Okay, let's my audience see who won
let's
this.
See.
Okay,
because I
don't even know myself. Okay?
Okay,
I do know, but I'm going to tell them. Okay, let's do it.
The nominees for Outstanding Younger Leading Actor and Actress all played the game of love.
However, only some of them got to pass go.
Many a tear has to fall.
For Outstanding Younger Leading Actor are
All My Children's Brian, The Teenage Romeo with Three Juliets, Matt Borlenghi. From As the World Turns, Holden. Holden's getting an award? Wait a minute. Holden, who had brain surgery and forgot that he was married to a mob, John Hensley. And from The Young and the Restless, Ryan, the cocky conniver who burned his candle at both ends. Scott Reeves.
And the winner is... Outstanding Younger Leading Actor is Matt Borlenghi, All My Children.
Thank you very much. A lot of people know already that I decided to go on to whatever else there is out there and try other things. There are people I'd like to thank, like Agnes Nixon and Felicia Monet Bear and the family and all my children that welcomed me into their arms. And oh, you know, my mom, my dad, my family, all that. And. This is great. Soap Opera Digest Magazine, thank you very much. Have a good night.
Matt, that's great. How did you feel holding that? I know there was a tearful thing there just a moment. You felt, couldn't talk anymore.
Yeah. It was, I really, there were.
You made your mother very happy. That was your mommy hugging you?
That was my mom that hugged me.
Hugged you?
Yeah, I mean, I wanted just once before I was really out of that world.
Uh-huh.
I wanted her to see what I'd been involved with and meet some of the people, you know, David Canary, who you
right.
know, saw Give Me a Hug also.
They're all going to miss you.
I miss them.
And
you're
going to miss them.
Yeah.
But do you think you might go back? Because they're asking, they want Brian Dean to come back.
Yeah.
Understand the people here in Hollywood or all my General Hospital, all of them are after you.
You found out about that, huh?
Yeah, I found out. They're all after you, Matt.
Right now.
Because the fan mail is so
Yeah, I mean, I really,
you got
like
fans
I was saying,
out there.